filming behind the scenes, eh?
Yeah. Behind the scenes of nothing.
Or can't you just transfer the loop over to the Mac?
Well, I'm going to have to bounce the loop once I'm done with it, because I can't get this program working. So I can just make one drum file.
Yeah.
I had a good one for a slowed down and make a good old groove one.
Hey guys, I'm just over at Hallam's place at the moment. We're sussing out drum loops, aren't we? I think. What are we doing?
Oh, yes.
Yes, use that one.
Is this a good pawn groove trap?
Sounds right to me. So we're just sussing our drum loops. I've enlisted Hallam to do a little track for my coffee and cigarettes project.
What's a good set speed? The porn song.
120?
Is that slightly too... 120. That was 120 before. I remember it was too slow. This is 140.
Mm. 140 is alright. Do you have anything that doesn't have so much of a kick in it?
Yeah.
Because that sounds like we're just...
gonna break into like punk or something.
It's just a single kick.
Yeah.
That bit better or anything?
Do you have anything like more jazzy?
Because
I'm thinking like more hi-hat sort of stuff. Or like minimalist techno or some shit.
I was just thinking more like classic funk rock.
Yeah. You got any drum and bass? Oh fuck no, dubstep!
Yeah, shuffle's gonna be too weird. It's gotta be straight.
Yeah.
Motown's gonna be too.
Oh, lounge here, ow! Ow! Ow!
Wrong kind of.
What was that?
So could you just tell us what program you're using and everything?
Sorry, just a very tiny little hit, just for my amusement. Alright, so what we're doing is using Cubase to run Easy Drummer.
Yep.
Unfortunately, I haven't quite got the program working on the Mac, because I'm running just GarageBand on the Mac, which is really good for tracking guitars for cheap. My computer over here is not so good for tracking guitars, so what we're going to do... or what we are doing is basically trucking the drums. New music lingo, never mind.
You wouldn't understand.
Yeah, so anyway, we're tracking these drums through Cubase and a program called Easy Drummer. Easy Drummer basically allows you to either program it hit by hit, which is kind of what I was doing a little bit, just adding some hits, or you can kind of go with the pre-programmed loops and then customize it, which is what I've just been doing. With some fills and some little hi-hat hits, just to sort of make it sound a little bit more human.
So we've just moved everything to the iMac, which is presently... It went okay, I think. It did, didn't it?
Went fine.
It went fine, there we go.
Maybe we're just going to have to track it.
The official word.
We might just have to track it with crappy speakers and then listen to it properly. Because this thing's all out of here. It's
going quite... The iMac speakers are fine.
Yeah, it just doesn't quite got the kick for the drums. Alright, so it's in GarageBand. So I think we're going to need some bass first. So I might use this bass as a nice four string.
Mm.
It has a pretty nice tone for what it is. And it should be nice and...
I did always like that bass, actually.
We've got a little bit of signal there. I've got no idea what I'm... I can sort of hear what I'm playing, but I'm going to need to track it with these so I can come up with a little bit of a nice bass groove.
I like that.
So, what software are you using on the Mac?
For this, we're just using GarageBand. So it comes with the computer. Pretty boring stuff. it's alright, we can just get away with registering later. This program here is MPEG SVX, which gives you MPEG tone on a computer without actually using the amps. So it's amp simulation software. This amp is actually what I used to have before I had to sell it for, you know, heroin money and things. So
like a typical bass player.
Yeah. So I'm just going to set up with the exact thing that I had. So I had an SVT810E. Might just take the mesh off. And our head, we're basically just using SVT 4 Pro. I might just put the ultra high on because it just gives it a little bit of depth with the slap bass. Let's hear how that sounds. This is going to be full of mistakes, but anyway.
Who cares? Awesome.
So it's the tone at least is sounding better.
Oh, sexy Alan
on the rocks. Yeah,
so we've taken a quick trip away from Alan's house because I was sick of hearing CD porn bass, and we're down in, where are we, Blakehurst? So we're in Blakehurst at the moment, checking out possible fishing spots. Oh, here we go. I had to climb up this. I can't see shit, but yeah, I had to climb up that. Fuck that. I don't have any balance as it is. I'm gonna try with a fucking fishing rod. Other than that, it's really nice. Dude, if there's another path up this way which is easier, I'm gonna kill you. So this is quite nice. All outdoorsy and stuff. To be honest, I haven't been up to Blakehurst for ages. Not since my grandmother passed away, and I haven't seen the side of Blakehurst, so here we are.
Hello.
On camera man love, nothing like it.
We've got proof now.
Proof of what?
Proof that I like you enough to hug you.
Whoa. Aww. Thanks gorgeous.
They do actually come and lock it.
Where we've parked, it was what, 6:30 when we got here?
Yeah,
so it was bang on 6:30 and the parking lot closes at 7, so we now have to scramble up the cliff.
You know,
avoid rabid tigers and shit.
Yeah.
And bears and
boat
drop bears and, you know, because it's Australia, so we have drop bears.
Drop bear?
So now we have to go back to the car and try and not get locked in.
No.
I am too unfit for this. Fuck. Oh, you go on and laugh. Frick.
No, I'm feeling like hurtling myself.
Oh, fuck. Oh good, we're getting in the car.
Yeah. We're gonna drive.
Good. Good, good, good.
Nearly there. Well, nearly out of town.
So where are we going next?
We go to a place called Yowie Bay.
Yeah.
Yowie Bay is where the guy at the fishing shop, where I bought that, where my fiance bought that rod from Christmas.
Yeah.
So he reckoned that Yowie Bay is a really good spot for catching squid. And squid, you in turn, you use as bait for catching jewfish,
among other big fish.
Oh.
So, that's the idea, is to see whether it's any good, whether we can get any kind of spot. Because on Google Earth, it's very full of boats and houses and private jetties. So it looks really hard to get close to the water unless you're right up at the one end where there's a path. So it looks like we're really close to Yowie Bay. Oh no, we're about 4 minutes away.
That's ages.
I thought we were a bit closer than we was.
A bit closer than we were, yeah. That's true.
Now we're gonna go.
So dude, does it feel weird calling Amy your fiance or what?
Not anymore, it did for a while there. Yeah. But which left are we going on? Fort Hacking Road. That's not this left. This is like 8 different ways you can go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're going the slight left, not the full left.
The slight left, okay.
Which I think needs to be in
the... Remember that, guys, we're going the slight left, not the full left.
Yeah.
So the full left, that'll fuck us up. If you get the slight left, we'll be okay.
This is the... I guess you could cast a squid jig that far out.
Hmm.
Wouldn't be too hard. I wonder if you actually walked to that little bit of sand there. I don't even know if it's high tide or low tide right now. I'd say low tide.
Hmm.
It's a high tide. Hmm. Oh, a fish gun. Look at it. Little mullet or something.